Welcome back to Let's Play Prophecy of the Moonlight Witch Blind. I'm Amethyst Lunatari. I've got some instructions here. Because this is a pain in the butt. Alright. Follow the path until it splits, then go east. East. Then when it comes to a large open area, go north. Is this the large open area? Follow the path. When it splits, go west. Go directly north after you go west. Is this directly north? Wait. Or is it... That's not directly. It says it's easy to miss. But I think we've been there. It makes an N shape. Wait. Yes, I'm looking at a walkthrough. If you follow this path, it will make an N shape. As you head south on the eastern part of the N. Okay, so the N goes around this way then. Okay. As you head south, right, which is this. I really want to get past this point. All I do is wander around for like almost the entire video. Or it was the entire video. You will reach a part of the path that has a Y shape with you being on the left fork of the Y. Okay, like this. Right? When you get there, go up to the right fork. You'll see a butterfly at a monument. Okay. Okay, examine the monument. So the butterfly we've already seen. I don't know why this is clicking. Hold on a second. Maybe that will fix it. As you... Okay, so the butterfly we've already seen, so that's why we're not going to see it again. Examine the monument. Okay, go back. Okay. Go back to the first area of the far. That's what I'm not clear on. We're supposed to just backtrack. Now go back to the first area of the forest and head west a screen from here. But be aware that near the exit is another monument. Do not examine it or you'll have to start over. I knew there was one we didn't examine. Okay, so it's not this. Right, so this is the Y. Okay, so we're heading to this on the Y. Right? And then this is the N. So we head back this way. Okay, this is the first area, okay. So I think we did it, we... And head west, a screen from here. Okay, do not examine this. Now look... Okay. Look around in this I'm gonna save here. Look around this area for the butterfly, it says. Didn't do that either. I'm in magic. We want data. Data. Stuff. Look around in this area for the butterfly. So I don't want to head off the screen. Or the butterfly might not show itself again, because we saw it before. I don't want to head off the screen. Loading. Alright, so I think we've already seen the butterfly, so we're gonna... Yeah, that's gotta be it. Making sure I'm loading, not saving. That would kill me. Okay, look around this area for the butterfly. Follow it to find the Algres. So we can't follow it. Is there another way to go? Maybe this way? That's a dead end. So I headed east and then south. That didn't work, so east and then north? I don't think it's here. The problem is we've already seen the butterfly, so it's not giving us further instruction. That's just... I don't know if it's on that screen or back over. Let's load. This one. So I tried it east and south, and I tried east and north. Right? Look different? I just head directly west. It does look different, doesn't it? I'm not sure. There's the butterfly. Alright, we gotta follow that. Hold on 1 second. They went up this way. Oh! Look! Here it says. Algres? Says Philly. Shirley says, is it? Philly says, wait, Algres. We won't harm you or the forest. We have a favor to ask you. Yurio says, please, Algres, listen to me. My friends were cursed by a spell. We want you to give us a little bit of your horn so we can make a potion to lift the curse. Philly says, we only need a little bit of powder. Please, Algres. Please share a little bit of your precious horn with us. What if it doesn't want to? Why should it care about us anyway? Algres nodded and stood still as if it was offering his horn. Thank you, Algres. Philly scraped a small portion off the horn while making sure not to frighten Algres. Thank you. This is enough. Yo-Yo says, thank you, Algres. Shirley says, I owe you. And away it goes. Goodbye, Algres, says Yurio. I can mix a potion with this. Let's return to Aldos. Yurio says, okay. Okay, that was something. New save. Thank God. Now I just have to get back. Should probably be easier than anything else. Now it says go east and then south. Okay. Well, what's up this way? Anything? Probably nothing, yeah. I'm supposed to go back to Aldos. East. And now south. Yay! Joy says, Yurio. Miria says, did you find an Algres? Pat says, I'm glad you're safe. The mayor says, I'm happy you returned safely. I didn't tell you, but the Forest of Deception was made by the Moonlight Witch Gweld to protect the forests and the animals within. Really? Yurio says. 20 years ago, Gweld was visiting and became concerned about the disappearing forests and dying animals. That's why she told us to build a village here and take care of the forests. That's how Tanariko Village began. Yo-Yo says, so that is why the forests remain today. Thanks to the Moonlight Witch, we were able to find an Algres horn. Philly says, we must thank the Moonlight Witch. Right. The mayor says, you should go now. You must make use of the Algres horn you had to try so hard to find. Return to your friends quickly and lift their curses. Yo-Yo says, Mayor, Joy, Pad, Miria, thank you for everything. We will go back at once and get Chris and Goose healed. Please excuse us. Excuse us. The mayor says, yes, go quickly. Goodbye. Are we just going to go back to... Okay. Yo-Yo, Shirley, and Philly found one of the sacred animals, Algres, in the Forest of Deception and got a small part of its horn. The three hurried back to Aldos to save Chris and Goose, who were suffering from the curse of the wizard Kajin. Good, because I really didn't want to run all the way back there and fight numerous monsters. Yay. Ryu now says, Yurio, I was worried about you. Who are your friends? This is Philly, the daughter of Riz the apothecary in Frenthy. Riz sent her to help us. This is Shirla, Goose's friend. All right. I'll do the paperwork for your friends at once. So did you get your medicine? We have the ingredients. All we need is to have Philly mix a potion from them. That's good. The curse will be lifted. I'll do the paperwork for your friends, so please hurry back to the inn. Thank you. Oh, we are fading. Okay, I wasn't sure. Morrison says, oh, Yurio, you're back. Mr. Morrison, how are they? Their condition is hanging in the balance. Dr. Fiello says, Yurio, where's Riz? I'm Philly, Riz's daughter. I came here in place of my mother. So she had a daughter. So, do you know how to make the potion? Yes, I know how to mix it. I'll prepare it right away. Yurio says, we're counting on you, Philly. And no pressure or anything. I'll do my best. Philly began mixing the potion. She took out several different herbs from her bag and weighed them carefully. Then she mixed them and diluted them with water. It was like she was making herb tea. Now we need to mix in some Algres horn, and it's done. Philly added the Algres horn powder and mixed until the color became uniform. A milky white potion was created. It's done. Please give this to your friends. Shirley helped Goose take the potion. Oh. Shirla? It's Shirla. Goose is healed. Ugh, what an awful thing to go through. Say, why are you here, Shirla? Don't you want me here? Yurio helped Chris take the potion. Yurio! Yurio! Chris is healed. Thank you, Yurio. The curse is gone. I can think straight now. Yay! Now who's gonna join the party and who's leaving? Chris and Goose were released from the curse, thanks to everyone's help. Yurio was sincerely grateful to those who helped him. Goose and Shirla talked to each other happily, rejoicing in the near reunion. I guess they're not mad at each other anymore. Yurio and others expressed their joy at seeing Chris and Goose well again. They talked for a while about the adventure Yurio and the company had while looking for an Algres horn. Goose says, Yurio, I owe you one. We decided to travel together again. Shirla says, we're leaving now. The sooner the better. The serious atmosphere of Aldos doesn't suit me. I want to travel carefree in my own way. Chris says, Goose? Shirla? You guys are leaving? I haven't thanked you yet, Shirla. Thank me? Don't bother. I've never been thanked by anyone in my life. Yurio says, but it's sad to say goodbye to you, Goose, Shirla. Goose says, hey, thanks. I can understand that you depend on me, but I'm a busy person. It's not that, Yurio says. Don't try to hide your feelings. When there's a parting, there's a chance for an encounter. I'm sure we'll meet again someday. Morrison says, Goose, I would like to say something as we part. What? We haven't been together long, but it was a pleasant journey. And one more thing. If you continue to practice thievery, please do it outside ambush. I don't want to catch you. Well, I can't promise you that. We're carefree thieves. Tomorrow is another day, you know? I expected you to say that, Goose. You're a model thief. Dr. Fiello says, you're a thief? How could you enter Aldos? An invisible barrier surrounds Aldos and doesn't let any evil-hearted people enter. Well, I guess they're not evil-hearted. Chris says, Goose is not a bad person. As far as I know, he never succeeded in stealing. Ouch! Don't remind me. Philly says, I think I know. After traveling with Shirla, I can say that she is a kind person. I think both Goose and Shirla have very pure hearts. Shirla says, thanks. I'm getting itchy listening to you guys. Same here, says Goose. We're going now. So long. Chris says, goodbye. Yurio says, see you again. Dr. Fiello says, Goose, don't try too hard. I know. Morrison says, take care. Philly says, goodbye. Okay, all the goodbyes have been said. They're gone, says Yurio. Chris says, we'll see them again someday. Yes. The doctor says, well, the curse is lifted, so I'd better go back to my clinic, too. It's time to kick out Irby, who's pretending to be sick. Otherwise, he will stay in my clinic forever. So long. Thank you for everything, Dr. Fiello, says Chris. Don't mention it. Morrison says, Yurio, Chris, it's now time for you to visit the Grand Cathedral. It is the final destination of your pilgrimage. Right, says Yurio. I'll wait for you here. I'll go back to Ambush after you have completed your worship at the cathedral. Philly says, I'll be waiting for you too. You'll travel westbound on your way back, right? Can I travel with you halfway? Absolutely. Philly says, same thing. Morrison says, view the last magic mirror carefully. I'll keep that in mind. I want to go visit Dr. Fiello as well, definitely. I'll talk to some people around here. You endured it well, Schraff says. This experience must have helped you grow. Get some rest here. Yeah, sure. Actually, I don't think we need any. We haven't, like, used any spells or anything. Well, too late. Alright, so if we go this way... Well, let's check in with him. This is a town of saints, so there's no tavern. I feel a bit empty, though, Otter says. I think a lot of these people will have the same thing to say, but... This is empty. That's empty, too. Oops. Aldos is like the capital for the Candon Chapel. That's where you can learn most spells, if you have the skills. Right. Perrin says, Dr. Fiello returned the book. I'm glad it helped. The one I just talked to. Have you seen the Three City Bridge? I think we've read that. A lot of people over here. Oh, what cute kids on a pilgrimage. I'm sure your parents are worried about you. Be sure to go straight home after praying at the Grand Cathedral. Oh, you're the guy who was looking for Dr. Fiello. Is this your friend who is sick? Dr. Fiello's great, isn't he? Huh? He's not the one that cured you? Anyway, I'm glad you're well. Oh. I almost fell in the drink. Can't fall in the drink. New. Dr. Fiello says, ha ha ha, Irby doesn't know I have been here all this time. I can't kick him out. I decided to let him stay until he wants to leave himself. You return to the village safely now. Congratulations on your recovery, Nurse Epine says. Yuria was running all over for you. Chris says, sorry to have been such trouble. I truly appreciate what Yuria did for me. Yuria says, don't say that. I'll blush. The nurse says, Yuria is cute. He's my type. Ruby says, they say Dr. Fiello will come back soon. We can sleep a little longer. Yeah, it's him right there. She's on a pilgrimage. Now, last time we found him by this windmill, but he wasn't over there now. I guess there's nobody here right now. I can't see where we're going. Alright, let's head back to the religious district. Let's go with the pastor here. Maybe not, but we are passing through here. Yeah, you could go around, I guess. Town area. Getting lost. Yeah, we got lost enough at the Forest of Deception. Just seeing if anyone has anything new to say. This is an awesome song. We can get in this way, right? Yeah. Alright, so this is the way in. You're entering the religious district where the priests live. Are you visiting the Grand Cathedral of Aldos? Yurio says, yes. We are pilgrims from Ragpick Village. I'm Yurio, and this is Chris. Alright. Only those who have been to the four shrines can enter this area. I must give you a test. If you can answer all questions correctly, I'll let you enter. There are five questions. Ready? You are allowed to discuss with each other. If you've been to the shrines, you should be able to answer them easily. Question 1. The shrines represent water, earth, fire, wind, and heavens. Which does the shrine in Dean represent? I can't remember. Earth? I'm afraid that's not the right answer. Relax and think harder. Let's save. Although I'm probably not gonna, like, load from that, but... Let's see, that's a good idea. What if we get it wrong too many times and it blocks us out? I don't think that would happen. But... Alright, I'm thinking water then. Water. Question 2, what does the shrine in Tagura represent? Is that one earth? Question 3, what does the shrine in Agunis represent? That one's fire. I know that one. Oh, didn't even cross them off the list, what we have. Figured we'd take those, like, answers off. Alright, that one's fire. Question 4, what does the shrine in Shifuul represent? I guess that one's wind. This last one must be heavens. Question 5. Did the magic mirrors show only the truth? Yes. I'm afraid that's not the right answer. Relax and think harder. Really? Okay, water. Earth. So they can show lies? Surprised about that. Wind. No. That's correct. The magic mirrors do not always show the truth. Prophecies are warnings, and problems can be avoided with enough effort. If you understand it, I'm sure you'll learn something from the Shrine of Heavens in the Grand Cathedral of Aldos. Please enter. Feel free to enter. Oh, okay. Religious district. So what's... anything interesting this way? No. Okay. Well, how do I get... in there? There's a doorway. We can't get to it. We always start off that way. Okay, never mind. I'm gonna look around in here. Rung says, "You're so young for pilgrims." I'm sorry. Age shouldn't matter. Isn't it this the age at which point they do the pilgrimage? Please make use of the experience you had during your journey and become adults with big hearts who will save the world. That's awfully specific. But thank you. So we'll go this way. You haven't been finding stuff lately. Should I praise you? You might need food. Normal mood? Weak from hunger, though. Figure you'd be in a bad mood because of that. Let's do the stat as a boost. Vicious food, so scoring critical hits. Gulps down the vicious food. I like that. Glick says, "Have you seen the magic mirror in the Grand Cathedral?" "No, not yet," says Yerio. "You've come this far. You're sure you should know by now that the magic mirrors don't just show beautiful images. The magic mirror in Oldos conveys the clearest message of all mirrors in the shrines. Don't be alarmed by what you see. Don't just be alarmed by the message. Think of what you should do about it, and then do it." Okay. Sounds like a plan. Hi. Jawa says, "Once they enter the Grand Cathedral, they stay inside for many days. They do their own laundry during their stay." Priests do laundry, too. Well, yeah, I figured they wear clothes. Even though they may be robes or something, they still need them to be clean. I guess this is the cathedral? I'm not even sure. There's someone here. Floy. "I came here to train myself so I can succeed to my family's canned spells. As expected, Oldos is a holy place. Here I understand how the canned and chapel used to be one branch of magic. There were probably great witches and sorcerers a long time ago." Okay. Percy says, "So you're visiting the cathedral? I've just seen the magic mirror. I've seen the mirrors at 5 shrines. The magic mirrors are truly wondrous. Even my old poor sighted eyes could clearly see the images in the magic mirrors in the shrine." Is this the way to the... I guess this is it. Warrior Monk says, "We appreciate your coming here, pilgrims. The Shrine of Heavens is inside the Grand Cathedral. You can only visit the Grand Cathedral once. It's been the rule since this cathedral was built. You must see everything carefully." I'm guessing this is the entrance to it. "Welcome to the Grand Cathedral of Oldos. Please enter." It says that again. I just want to see if there's anything else to see besides that. I don't think so. Did I go in here? I think so. Yep. Talk to him. Yep, okay. I suppose must be annoyed all these people passing through here because it's the only way to get anywhere. Oh, found a fool cure potion, nice. How many full cure potions do I have? 9 of them. I don't think I've ever used any. Anyway, I'm gonna call in an episode here. Stay tuned for the next episode when we visit the Grand Cathedral of Aldos and observe the events in the final magic mirror on Yurio and Chris's pilgrimage. Thanks so much for watching. See you next time, and always seek adventure.